Alright. Picked up a new sword from Cult of Athena. Comes in the Royal Armory box. It's a nice box. Wood cord scabbard here. Some 5 minutes. Brass into it. Wipe off this grease. This is, I haven't mentioned it yet, but it should be in the title. It's a windless, single-edged arming sword, 15th century arming sword. I guess you'd call it a back sword, It's very fashion-like also. Got it from Cult of Athena. Had them do the sharpening. Sharpened the other one myself. Have a, the other windless, single hand. Royal Armory sword. Can't remember what exact name of it. It's like the Wakefield hanger copy. I had to get that one on it. Different site where they didn't offer the sharpening, so I sharpened that one on myself. Sharpness is pretty decent. Pretty much how Cult of Athena usually does it. Angle's a little steep. Touch it up later after I'll cut with it, and once it needs sharpened, I'll just smooth out the angle. So I do my own sharpening. Hilt on it is pretty nice. Grip feels good. Cinched upper pommel. Pinned. Gap in the blade where the cross guard meets. Kind of hard to see. I gotta do it here, but it's really tight. Throw this glove on. Sharpen down the back edge, the false edge, to about here. Rest of it's dulled on the back, as it should be for a single edge sword. Can still kinda, maybe, do a finger over the guard. It's a little harder where the handle is offset, like a falchion. Like a fashion or a big kitchen knife. Blade length, I believe, is just a little over 31 inches. Weight is about 2 pounds, a little over 2 pounds, 12 ounces, according to the website. Feels pretty good. Not super light for an arming sword, but it is very, very wide blade. But also very thin. I think it's like a little under 5 millimeters, maybe 4 something, and then tapers down to a little over 2 towards the end of the blade. Definitely gonna have to get it out and cut with it.